How can you find high-profit Amazon FBA products for free and without using third-party software tools? Well, Amazon made their own tool, and this is called the Product Opportunity Explorer. It's also free and is being rolled out as a feature to all professional seller accounts. And even though it's free, this is one of the most powerful tools yet. As a random example, it can show you how many new products were launched in a niche in the past year, and also how many of those launches were actually successful. And by the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to use Product Opportunity Explorer to find your next idea. So smash like. My name is Dan Rogers. I've been selling on Amazon for over 5 years and I've trained over 1,000 sellers one-on-one. I now focus on sharing my knowledge about e-commerce. I'm very happy to be back doing that on the Just One Dime channel. And today's training contains a fraction of what we include in the Grow course, which is part of the Amazon FBA Mastery membership. And if you're interested in learning more about that, you can go to jod.com/freedom to apply today. To access Product Opportunity Explorer, go to Seller Central, click on the three horizontal lines in the top left corner, and under Growth, click Product Opportunity Explorer. But if you don't see that option on your account, you can also email this email here, and we'll drop it in the description below. But email this email and request access. That way you may be able to become a beta tester of this new feature. Once in the Opportunity Explorer, you can select the market you wish to research. And this currently works for the United States, United Kingdom, Germany, France, Italy, and Spain. In the search box, you can then search a keyword or a search term as the basis of your research. But below, you will also see a group of recommended niches that Amazon suggests based on your existing product line. Now, this focuses on discovering niches, and a niche is a collection of products which together satisfy the same customer need. But various customer queries or search terms or keywords will all lead to the same need. So in this way, you can have multiple search terms all leading to that same need and that same niche. But if you do choose to click on one of the Amazon suggested niches here, that's going to take you straight to the niche details, which we're going to cover later within this video. Part 1. Discover new product niches. This is best when you're looking to stumble upon brand new ideas from scratch, or new ideas based on your existing niche and product line. Step number 1. This is to insert a broad keyword describing your overall category. For example, let's use meditation. Then click the search icon. This will return a variety of niches in the category. Step 2. This is to filter results. Once the results load, under the search box, click filter results. In the pop-up window, select the price and set your minimum average price. This is the lowest average price that you're willing to accept for a returned niche. We will use $35 as we're aiming to find a product that we can sell for more than this. Then click submit. Then scroll down to see the niche's results. And before step 3, let's briefly cover how to read all of these columns. Amazon labels each niche as a customer need, that is column 1. This is important because customers use different search terms, column 2, to find products that satisfy that same need. So remember that niche and need, they are interchangeable and mean the same thing from here on. Search volume past 360 days and also past 90 days. This indicates how many times customers typed in any of the different search terms pointing to this need and this niche. And search volume is a very important one because remember, a search on Amazon is a search to buy. So this directly indicates demand. Search volume growth past 360 days and past 90 days. This indicates the change in search term volume for all the search terms when comparing last year to the current year, if you're looking at 360 days, or the previous quarter to the current quarter, if you're looking at 90 days. And that can of course indicate seasonality. Units sold past 90 days. This is of course the number of products sold in this niche in the past quarter. Number of top clicked products. This represents the number of products within this niche according to Amazon. Amazon only includes the products which together are responsible for 80% of the clicks within this niche. They discard the lower clicked products, making up the last 20%. So that is what this number refers to, the number of products making up that 80% of clicks. So very loosely, this could be seen as the number of competitors, but do remember that volumes are going to be different, sales are going to be different. So seeing a lot of top click products does not necessarily mean it's too competitive or a worse market than another. Average price past 90 days, and this is the average selling price of products within this niche over the past quarter. Step 3. This is to narrow down the niches. After extensively testing this, it's not worth drawing too much insight from the units sold or number of top clicked products, but the most important columns are top search terms, because these are the most used search terms. They are what you should use to research the niche and need further. If an idea does prove high potential, these will also be crucial keywords for your listing and PPC advertising. Search volume, because a search on Amazon is a search to buy, so it directly indicates the level of demand, and lower search volumes will have lower sales. Search volume growth past 90 days, because this may indicate seasonality, if there's an extreme increase here or decrease. Average price, as this indicates whether the niche will support your goal sell price and what you want to sell the product for. Now, based on this, select 5 niches or needs that you wish to research further, but keep this page open. You're simply going to go to each customer need and you're going to right click and open it in a new tab. Let's use steel drum as our example, as it has significant search volume, appears relatively small in terms of product size. It has a high sell price and just seems like an interesting niche. You would do this for each of your 5 ideas. Part 2, evaluate product niches. This is when you're going to begin exploring whether this is a good niche to sell in or not. And this is also the page you're going to land on if you choose any of Amazon's suggested niches, as we covered in the very beginning. But now that we've chosen our 5 niches, we're going to showcase our one example. Here's how we're going to evaluate this. This is the niche details page, so you're now evaluating a specific product niche and customer need. The top overview breaks down based on the past quarter, that's 90 days, this niche's search volume, average price, and search volume growth, among others. Scroll down and there are 3 main menu items, and these are very important. You have products, search terms, and insights. Evaluate the niche insights. First, click on insights. This will provide a powerful overview of the niche, and here you can establish 3 points. Ease of entry, by looking at the number of new products launched past 180 days and comparing it to the number of successful launches past 180 days, you can establish the ease of entry. Here, there were 12 new products launched and 8 were considered successful. So that roughly gives us a 67% success rate. Brand dominance. By looking at the top 5 products click share and the top 5 brands click share, which show the percentage of all customer clicks on the top 5, you can establish if the niche is brand dominated. Ensure these are both below about 50%, but generally the lower the better. Seller experience. By looking at average review rating, average out of stock rate, and average listing quality, you can establish if these are new or seasoned sellers. Here, listing quality and review ratings are very high, with a relatively low out of stock rate, so this niche has very seasoned sellers. Evaluate the niche products. So now that you have an overall feel for the niche from the insights page, you're going to click on products. This shows you the specific products within this niche, and by default it's ordered by clickshare past 90 days. This is good, as it shows them in order of how often customers click on that specific product. So the most clicked is at the top, second most clicked is next, and so on. Most of the columns here are self-explanatory, but you can determine 3 key insights here. Review importance and ease of entry. If the click share is only high on those with high total reviews, Then customers place high importance on reviews when they're making their purchase decision. But if the click share is spread out and similar on lower review and higher review listings, this tells you customers place less importance on reviews, value product design much more, and are willing to buy from lower review offerings. This indicates easier market entry. Here we see a click share of 3.1% on a listing with 719 reviews, and a comparable click share of 2.7% on a listing with only 26 reviews. That indicates customers don't place too much importance on reviews here. Price sensitivity. If the click share is much higher on low average selling price past 90 days listings, then customers are price sensitive, as they're mainly clicking on low price listings. But if the click share is similar at varying prices or even higher on higher sell price listings, then customers are less price sensitive and they're willing to pay higher prices here. Here we see click share of 3.9% at $34 sell price and a comparable click share of 3.1% at a $73 sell price for a very similar product type. This indicates customers are not very price sensitive in this niche. Most ideal product type. By looking at the specific product types in the images and comparing these with the related click share percentages, you can establish the specific product type and even bundles that customers desire most. And those that customers click on most, highest click share, are of course the ones that grab their attention most and that likely satisfy their need most, and therefore are most suited to the niche. So this will generally help you decide on the best type of product to build out for this niche. In this case, we see the drums without the stands. They tend to draw the most customer interest, and those with bundled accessories are the most desired, and this would be the ideal product type to build for this niche. A side note here that sub-niching is also possible, for example going with the drums with stands, that lower click share area, provided there's enough search volume and demand there. Evaluate the niche search terms. So now that you've identified the ideal product type to build for the niche, click on search terms. This page provides you with the search terms that customers type in to satisfy this need, or in other words, to find this niche. By default, they're ordered by search volume past 90 days, so it shows them to you in order from the most to the least used by customers. And you can use this data as follows. The search volume growth quarter over quarter and also year over year. This is showing you the changes in how often customers search these specific terms. And of course, that can indicate seasonality in the niche, particularly with quarter over quarter. The click share past 90 days indicates the number of customer clicks onto products in this niche generated from this specific keyword compared to all of the other keywords. As an example, tong drum is the keyword customers type 25% of the time before clicking on products in this niche. This is why it has a 24.9% click share. Steel tong drum, on the other hand, is typed 20% of the time. And since we know that those two keywords really result in a lot of clicks within this niche, they are extremely important keywords for us to research this niche further, but they also tell you the exact type of product that customers are searching for and the exact type of product you should build. For example, that it should be steel. So that search term is also very important for product development. The search conversion rate past 90 days indicates the percentage of purchases in this niche that originated from this specific search term compared to all purchases in this niche from all the other search terms in the past 90 days. As an example, steel tong drum was responsible for 8.5% of the sales made in this niche, while hand pan was responsible for only 1.2% over the past quarter. So similar to click share, but can actually help you confirm what you've learned in click share, this conversion rate tells you the most important keywords that tend to convert customers. And a pro tip here, even if you're already selling a product, come in here and use this data. Check the keywords with the highest click share and search conversion rate and ensure you have these on your listing. This page is extremely valuable in finding your highest converting keywords, also optimizing your PPC campaigns, and even finding low competition keywords. Then we have the top three clicked products, and this column shows you the three products customers clicked on most after they searched this search term. And these will usually be your top competitors. So you can learn from these sellers. You can learn from their main images as well as product design, because they are generating the highest click-through rate in this niche. Evaluate Amazon search results for the niche. Lastly, in your niche evaluation, take your highest converting relevant keyword and go and type it into Amazon exactly as a customer would. In this case, it would be steel tongue drum, because that has 8.5% search conversion rate. Type it into Amazon and click search. Then skip the sponsored results at the very top and evaluate the first page of results. In this example, this is the first line of organic results. We see low review listings ranking very well, and that shows us ease of entry and that customers will accept lower reviews. We also see that customers tend to prefer offerings around the $60 price point. And this niche is just that, a niche. We see lower sales volumes, but at these higher price points, lower sales volumes can actually be viable. And at this stage, now that you've identified the niche and the highest converting search terms, you can use that same search term to perform all of your other product research procedures with other software tools, just like Niche Hunter by Just One Dime. And remember, at this point, you are going to repeat this process for the five niches that you found earlier. Choose your niche. And lastly, based on your remaining niches and your evaluation, choose the absolute best niche as well as product type in that niche that you want to build to best satisfy that customer need. And well done, you're now equipped to uncover and evaluate product niches as well as draw valuable insights on your existing product niches, and all doing it with data directly from Amazon. And remember to like this video and comment for me below if you have access to this feature. To take your Amazon seller journey to the next level, do remember this video was inspired by a single lesson within Amazon FBA Mastery. So if you want more on this, like this, and another 149 lessons like this, then go to jod.com/freedom. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss our next upload, and I will catch you in one of the next videos.